After you have selected your initial accounting settings, you can add accounting information that you want to bring with you. This includes your beginning balances, your list of customers, unpaid customer invoices, your list of vendors, and unpaid vendor bills. If you don't have anything to add, click No, Nothing to Add. If you do have this information but want to enter it later, choose Skip Setup for now. Otherwise, click Yes, Continue to Setup. Enter your beginning balances date. Determine which date you want to start tracking your transactions with our software, then use the day before as your beginning balance date. If you downloaded the account trial balance report from your last software or have it saved in a spreadsheet, you can easily import it here. Your spreadsheet just needs three columns for the account name, the debit amounts, and the credit amounts. I've got a sample spreadsheet here of my trial balances, so I can either enter these manually or import the file and make sure my accounts match up. I'll review both ways. First, let's import my trial balance spreadsheet. This will prevent me from having to data enter the amounts for each account. Before I upload my file, I'm going to review the chart of accounts that have been added so far. If I need to add more accounts, I can do this right here. Drag your file or choose it on your computer and click Save and Continue. If there are any accounts in your file that don't exactly match the account names in Patriot, you'll simply choose the matching account. In these cases, there was a minor spelling difference. I can still add new accounts here if needed. Click Save and Continue. Here are the account balances that were imported from my spreadsheet. If I need to make any edits, I can do so. Otherwise, click Save and Continue. Let's take it back a couple steps and manually enter my beginning balances instead of importing from a spreadsheet. If you're coming from another accounting software, we recommend you having your trial balance report in front of you. Enter balances in the corresponding debit or credit column. You can add any accounts that were not previously added in the setup, and you can save this page and come back later. The total debits and credits must balance before you can continue to the next step. You can import customers from a spreadsheet or enter your customers manually. If you don't have customers or have no outstanding customer invoices, you can continue without importing customers to skip this step. To import your customers, simply upload your file, map the fields, and enter any additional information needed. Once your customers have been entered, add any outstanding invoices waiting to be paid. The total balance of your invoices must match the beginning balance entered for accounts receivable. You can choose to save any products or services that were added when you entered your outstanding invoices. Next, you can import vendors from a spreadsheet using the same process as the customer import or manually enter your vendors. If any of your vendors require a 1099 at year end, the information can be added here as well. Once your vendors have been entered, add any outstanding bills you owe that need to be paid. The total balance of your bills must match the beginning balance entered for accounts payable. Finally, review your trial balance to make sure the information entered is accurate. These are the journal entries we will make for you. Then click Continue. Your accounting setup is now complete.